Christ, true God and true man, promises new life in Him. Jesus Christ, true God and true man, promises new life in Him. Jesus Christ, true God and true man, promises new life in Him.
Good evening and a hearty welcome to one and all to the Mass of the Holy Chrism. The purpose of this evening celebration is to reflect on the gift of the ministerial priesthood to the entire Church. This is known as the Chrism Mass. The Chrism Mass is the Mass which most clearly demonstrates the unity shared between a bishop and his priest. At this Mass, priests renew their priestly promises of prayer, obedience, and celibacy, and recommit themselves to the Lord's service. The Archbishop receives their promises, reminds them of their responsibilities, and then blesses the sacred oils of catechumens and the oil of the sick and oil of the chrism, which will be used in the administration of the sacraments throughout the archdiocese for the year. Since the Archbishop is the only minister in the Archdiocese who may consecrate Chrism, this Mass highlights his ministry and our union with him as priest and laity. Let us experience the divine grace in the Holy Mass of the Chrism.
Let us all stand and sing the entrance hymn as the principal celebrant, along with the concelebrants, proceeds to the altar.
Holy people, God chosen people, sing praise to the Lord.
Raise, take In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear sisters and brothers in Christ, this evening we are gathering here for Chrism Mass. Two important things will take place during this Chrism Mass. The first one is the bond and unity between the bishop and the priest, and also among the priests themselves, one presbyterium, the presbyterate of the Archdiocese of Hyderabad, that bond unity is to be reflected in this Chrism Mass. At the same time, they also renew their vows of obedience to the bishop during this Chrism Mass. Also, the relationship between the priest and the faithful also is to be reflected in this Mass. Second thing is about the blessing of three kinds of holy oils. The catechumen oil, before somebody is baptized, they use during the preparatory stage, who are called catechumens. For that period of time, preparation for baptism, the oil is used, catechumen oil, and the blessing of this catechumen oil takes place first in this Mass. Then secondly, the holy oil for the sick people, of the sick. Secondly, the blessing of this oil takes place. And lastly, the second oil is used for the anointing of the sick. We used to call it last sacrament. Not at all, it is the last sacrament. But oil is used so that the healing, both spiritual healing and also healing from the sins, will also take place using this holy oil of the sick. The third one is chrism. And this chrism oil, you know, is used at the time of baptism, time of confirmation, and also priestly ordination. And that is chrism oil. And the blessing of these three oils also will take place. And this blessed oils will be used for the 1 year, from today until coming year again, Chrism Mass, this oil will be used. Let us pray in a special way that the belongingness of to one presbyterate and also the unity and the bond between the bishop and the priest and priests among themselves and all of us with our own faithful will further strengthen further and further, that we continue to build our Catholic communities in all our parishes. In order to celebrate the sacred Eucharist in a worthy manner, first and foremost, let us call to our mind our sins and our failures and ask for God's pardon. I confess to Almighty God,
brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned,
my thoughts or my words, what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Contrite of heart.
Let us pray. O God, who anointed your only begotten Son with the Holy Spirit and made him Christ and Lord, graciously grant that, being made sharers in his consecration, we may bear witness to your redemption in the world. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Now we enter into the second part of the Holy Eucharist, namely the liturgy of the Word of God. The first reading explains the role of the ministerial priesthood. As the ministers of God, it is the duty of every priest to give the oil of gladness to comfort all who mourn and bring good news to the oppressed. They are a people whom the Lord has blessed to display God's glory. Let us now listen attentively to the first reading.
మొదటి పఠనము యెషయా గ్రంథము 61వ అధ్యాయము 1-3 వచనములు మరియు 6:8-9 వచనములు. బుక్ ఆఫ్ ఐజయా చాప్టర్ 61:1-3, 6, 8, and 9. ప్రభు అయిన యావే నన్ను అభిషేకించెను, తన ఆత్మతో నన్ను నింపెను, పేదలకు శుభవార్తను ప్రకటించుటకును, కృంగిపోయిన వారికి ఉత్సాహము పుట్టించుటకును, బందీలకు విముక్తియు, చెరలో ఉన్న వారికి విడుదలయు లభించునని తెలియజేయుటకును అతడు నన్ను పంపెను. ప్రభు అనుగ్రహ వత్సరమును గూర్చియు, మన దేవుడు శత్రువులను శిక్షించు దినమును గూర్చియు ప్రకటించుటకును, శోకించు వారిని ఓదార్చుటకును అతడు నన్ను పంపెను. సియోనునందు దుఃఖించు వారికి బుగ్గికి బదులుగా పూలదండ ఇచ్చుటకును, శోక వస్త్రమునకు మారుగా ఆనంద తైలమును ఒసగుటకును, విచారించువారు స్తుతిగీతము పాడునట్లు చేయుటకును అతడు నన్ను పంపెను. తన కీర్తి కొరకు ప్రభువే స్వయముగా నాటుకొనిన నీతి వృక్షములు అని ఆ దుఃఖార్తులకు పేరిడుదురు. మీరు మాత్రము ప్రభు యాజకులుగాను మన దేవుని పరిచారకులుగాను గణితుకెక్కుదురు. మీరు జాతుల సొత్తును అనుభవింతురు, దానిని దక్కించుకునినందులకు గర్వింతురు. ప్రభు ఇట్లనుచున్నాడు, ప్రభుడనైన నేను నీతిని అభిమానింతును, పరపీడనము దుష్టవర్తనమును అసహించుకుందును. నేను నమ్మదగిన తనముతో నా ప్రజలను బహూకరింతును, వారితో శాశ్వతముగా నిబంధనము చేసుకుందును. వారు జాతులన్నిటినీ సుప్రసిద్ధులగుదురు, వారి సంతానమునకు ఖ్యాతి కలుగును. వారిని చూచిన వారెల్లరూ నేను వారిని దీవించితినని గుర్తింతురు. ఇది ఏలిన వారి వాక్కు.
పవిత్ర తైలముతో అభిషేకించితిని. నా బలము ఎల్ల వేళలా అతనికి తోడుగా నుండును. నా శక్తి అతనిని ఫలాద్యుని చేయును.
Taken from the book of Revelation. This reading enlightens us that Jesus Christ is the beginning and the end. He is the Alpha and the Omega. Through his precious blood, he has washed away our sins and anointed us as a priest, prophet, and king. As a chosen people, we must be a faithful witness to bring glory to the name of Jesus and to establish his kingdom on this earth.
யோவான் கருளை பெற்ற தீழு வெளிப்பாட்டிலிருந்து வாசகம். 1 அதிகாரம் உயிருள்ள இறை வார்த்தைகள் 5 முதல் 8 வரை. ரெவலேஷன் 1:5-8. ஆசியாவில் உள்ள திருச்சபைகளுக்கு கடிதம். ஆசியாவில் உள்ள 7 திருச்சபைகளுக்கும் யோவான் எழுதுவது. இருந்தவரும் இருக்கின்றவரும் வரவிருக்கின்றோருமான கடவுளிடமிருந்தும் அவரது அரியணை முன் நிற்கும் கிறிஸ்துவிடமிருந்தும் உங்களுக்கு அருளும் அமைதியும் உரித்தாகுக. இந்த கிறிஸ்துவே நம்பிக்கைக்குரிய சாட்சி, இறந்தோருள் முதலில் உயிர் பெற்று எழுந்தவர், மண்ணுலக அரசர்களுக்கு தலைவர். இவர் நம்மீது அன்பு கூர்ந்தார். தமது சாவு வாயிலாக நம் பாவங்களிலிருந்து நம்மை விடுவித்தார். ஆட்சி உரிமை பெற்றவர்களாக, அதாவது நம் கடவுளும் தந்தையுமானவருக்கு ஊழியம் புரியும் குருக்களாக நம்மை ஏற்படுத்தினார். இவருக்கே மாட்சியும் ஆற்றலும் என்றென்றும் உரியன. ஆமேன். இதோ அவர் மேகங்கள் சூழ வருகின்றார். அனைவரும் அவரை காண்பர். அவரை ஊடுருவ குத்தியோரும் காண்பர். அவர் பொருட்டு மண்ணுலகின் குலத்தார் அனைவரும் மாரடுத்து புலம்புவர். இது உண்மை. ஆமேன். அகரமும் நகரமும் நானே என்கிறார் கடவுளாகிய ஆண்டவர். இருந்தவரும் இருக்கின்றவரும் வரவிருக்கின்றவரும் எல்லாம் வல்லவரும் அவரே. இது ஆண்டவர் வழங்கும் அருள்வாக்கு.
Thank you. Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 4, verses from 16 to 21, on page 61, New Testament. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, he went to the synagogue on the Sabbath day, as was his custom. He stood up to read, and the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was given to him. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim the release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." And he rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the attendant, and sat down. The eyes of all in the synagogue were fixed on him. Then he began to say to them, "Today, this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." This is the gospel of the Lord.
My dear sisters and brothers in Christ, on the occasion of Chrism Mass, basing on the theme, the priesthood, we have listened to the Word of God, and we will have few reflections and applications to our own lives. As we know, there is the Catholic Church priesthood of two kinds, the baptismal priesthood, which is obtained by everybody who is baptized, and also the ministerial priesthood, which is a special call given by God Himself to each one. Therefore, also, this would be applicable to all the faithful as they share in the general priesthood of Christ by baptism and also the sacrament of confirmation. The first reading from Isaiah connected to the anointment, the call, the anointment, and why a person is called, anointed, the specific purposes for this anointment are clearly told to us in the first reading. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has anointed me. The purpose, to bring the good tidings to the afflicted, to bind the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and also to proclaim the year
of Lord's favor, etc. Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, the priest who is called with a special call personally to do the same, to proclaim the good news to the poor and afflicted, to bind the brokenhearted, to liberate people from all kinds of chains, spiritual, material, and everything, psychological, there are many, many chains tied up with in different ways and different things. That is why the priest is chosen and anointed to give, to bring liberation to all the people of all kinds. That's the purpose of being called and also anointed. And also to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. And also Holy Father has declared this year as the Jubilee of Mercy, a year of God's favor, mercy, the merciful, the face of Jesus. Jesus is the merciful face of Jesus himself. Naturally, every priest called by name to this ministerial priesthood also has to be the face of mercy. And also in the second reading from Book of Revelation, it's connected to the Son of God, Jesus himself, as he came, the beloved Son of God came into this world, became one of us, and died on the cross, and shed his own blood to redeem us from the slavery of sin. And also, the priests are other Christ. That's the connection, and also he is Alpha and Omega, is everything. And naturally, priest has to be everything to everybody. It's also connected to the priesthood only. And also in the gospel today, from Luke chapter 4, same theme running through. Actually, the Old Testament quotation, Jesus repeats in the same way. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because of He has anointed me to preach the good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim the release to the captives and recovering of the sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. Then, of course, he closed the scripture and began to say, today, this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing, referring to himself. Therefore, my dear sisters and brothers in Christ, Jesus is the eternal high priest. The priests are chosen and anointed to share in the priesthood of Christ. This ministerial priesthood is not through or does not derive from baptism, not from the sacrament of confirmation, nor from the Christian community, but through a special call given by God and from another high priest. Also, this anointing is done by another high priest, the bishop. And the priests share in the priesthood of the bishop. That's why there is only one bishop in every diocese. And also, though they receive the priestly ordination, priesthood through the priestly ordination, they have to get their faculties from the local ordinary. That's the meaning. Local ordinary, there's only one head there, one priest, one priesthood, and also priests share in the priesthood of Christ through the bishop only. Therefore, he has to also get the faculties to use this priestly ministry and all services connected to the priest himself. And also this is done by the bishop laying his hands upon a candidate and praying to quote, "We ask you, all-powerful Father, give this servant of yours the dignity of presbyterate. Renew the spirit of holiness within him. By this divine gift, may he attain the second order in the hierarchy and exemplify the right conduct in his life." These are the words pronounced while giving priestly ordination by the bishop himself. A question continues still to be asked even today is, what is a priest? There still seems to be identity crisis regarding the priests across the society. This has been also permeated the church circles. The people still are confused about the identity of the priest. Is a teacher? Is a social worker? Or is a marriage counselor? Or is only administrator? See, the images the people have, they identify the priest with these things, that's why they put question marks. What is he? Is he a social worker? And things like that, and things like that. This shows there's a confusion in the minds of the society itself. Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, to understand the true essence of the priesthood, one has to ask a simple, and that also is a basic question. What does a priest do after priestly ordination? Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, after the priestly ordination, a priest is able, one, to call God down upon the altar in the sacrifice of the Holy Mass every day. That's the power a priest gets to call God from heaven onto the altar.
He is the eternal high priest
of Mass every day.
The priests are chosen and anointed,
yes, sisters and brothers in Christ,
to share
the second
in
one,
the priesthood of Christ.
He becomes able,
this ministry is a priesthood,
the words of absolution and forgives sins. Now when Jesus tells your sins are forgiven, then they find fault with him. Pharisees, only God can forgive, and this man claims to be God and he is forgiving. Only God, and here is a human person, anybody like anybody else, priest is like anybody else, but also still he wants a priesthood,
the bishop,
he will be able to absolve
the priest share
the sins,
the priesthood of the bishop,
confession. That
That's
is the
why
power
there is only one bishop to in every diocese,
priesthood,
and
also and brothers in Christ.
Though
the third one is, he will be able to teach as the official representative of Christ and Holy Mother Church. These are three specific tasks for the powers
that's
the priest gets by ministerial priesthood.
One priest, one priesthood, and also priests share
Paul
in the priesthood of Christ through the
addressing
bishop,
the World Council of Churches said, my name is Peter. The Pope knew who he was, what he was, and also what he meant by saying this way. And also his listeners also knew what he meant. Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, Pope Paul VI was not looking for an answer to his identity. We priests, therefore, should not have any identity crisis. We are priests of God. That's our identity. We are other Christ. Therefore, our name is always Christ. Our name, as Pope Paul VI said, my name is Peter, meaning he was the successor of Saint Peter. My name, my identity is Peter. So also, our identity as priests is Christ. That is our identity. Therefore, a priest has to be totally available towards God and consequently towards the church and to the service to which he has dedicated himself totally. The priesthood can never become for a priest a side occupation. There is also a twofold dimension to the priesthood. The first one is the vertical dimension, and this identifies the priest with Christ's priesthood, Christ's priest. That's why we are called Alter Christus. That's the vertical dimension. And the second dimension is the horizontal dimension. And this identifies the priest, rather, horizontal dimension, and this relates him to the needs of the people. Vertical dimension and horizontal dimension, that is the cross if you see. Vertical dimension, horizontal dimension. These are the two dimensions of the priesthood, dear sisters and brothers in Christ. There seems to be a tendency these days to emphasize the horizontal dimension and minimize the vertical dimension. This way, a priest will put his very vocation in a risk of abandoning it. There has to be a proper balance between the two. The stronger the vertical dimension, the stronger will be also the horizontal dimension. And there has to be a proportion between the two. Two are very necessary, but a proper proportion between the two. As I used to say, the image of the priest has to be in the minds of the faithful and also the society today. What should the priest carry, the image? I say this way, the image of the priest, first one is, he should be a holy priest. Image, somebody sees anybody, any of us priests, we should strike to them that we are holy persons, holy people. That's the image a priest must carry, especially today, the present day world. The second image also is praying priest. Praise who prays. He has to be a man of prayer. Then only he can lead also the flock entrusted to his care, to the prayer and all that. And Jesus, how much he prayed every day, though he was doing all the time God's work among the people only, but he never, ever identified his ministry with the prayer. Oh, my ministries are my prayer. My apostolates are my prayer. Again, why should I pray? That's already God's work. That's we justify this way. But Jesus never ever did that, in spite of doing all the time among the people. But he took time to go by himself and prayed. And there was no time during daytime. He went and spent whole night in prayer. Therefore, the priest, the image, the priest has to carry today a praying priest. And also, his primary task is to proclaim the word of God. Preach the word of God. So the priest has to be a preaching priest. Preaching priest. A priest who preaches the word of God effectively, fruitfully. That's another image. The fourth image I used to say is priest has to be people's priest. We are ordained for people, therefore we need to be men of people. Therefore, people's priest. And the last one is also working priest. St. Paul says, though I have right to receive remuneration from you, but not to give bad example, I work. Though he was working all the time, but still he was also doing even to earn his own things also. So priest has to be today a working priest These are the five images. In Telugu, it sounds very well. It always starts with pa, pi, pa. And it sounds always pa, pa. Modatidi prajalu gurtinchedi, eduru chusedi, guru ela undali ee rojullo, mottamodaldi variki undalsinatuvanti image aa guruvu pavitra guru. Pavitra guruvu, pradhinche guruvu, prasanginche guruvu, prajala guruvu, panichese guruvu, with all five. These are the things, a few reflections, my dear sisters and brothers in Christ, especially my dear priests, that today being the Chrism Mass and also the priesthood is the theme and also the bond that exists between the bishop and the priest, among the priests, and all of us with our own faithful are reflecting. Therefore, these are some of the few reflections I have shared with you regarding the priesthood. Let us examine ourselves. Where are we with regard to these things? If we find ourselves wanting, let us immediately say mea culpa and rectify ourselves and improve these images so that our apostolates, our ministries, priestly ministry, priestly life becomes very effective and fruitful.
Renewal of commitment to priestly service. Now the priests renew their vows and recommit themselves to serving the church and its people. It's a time for the priest to pause and ask themselves if they are fulfilling their ordination promises to serve God's people with a kind and generous heart. This renewal of commitment to priestly service is performed every year during what the Roman Catholic Church calls as the Mass of the Holy Chrism. I request all the faithful gathered here to pray for your priest. We ask forgiveness for our own insufficiency. I invite you to join with us now in asking God's forgiveness for our sinfulness and weakness. As we priests prepare ourselves to renew our commitment, I request all the faithful gathered here to stand as the choir sings the hymn to the Holy Spirit.
Santi Spiritus, Veni
Now the priests, through the renewal of their commitment to priestly service, express their faithfulness to the church and to the Archbishop.
Beloved sons, on the anniversary of that day when Christ our Lord conferred his priesthood on his apostles and on us, are you resolved to renew in the presence of your bishop and God's holy people the promise you once made?
I am.
Are you resolved to be more united with the Lord Jesus and more closely conformed to him, denying yourselves and conforming those promises about sacred duties towards Christ's church, which prompted by love of him, you willingly and joyfully pledged on the day of your priestly ordination?
I am.
Are you resolved to be faithful stewards of the mysteries of God in the Holy Eucharist and other liturgical rites, and to discharge faithfully the sacred office of teaching, following Christ, the head and shepherd, not seeking any gain, but moved only by zeal for souls?
I am.
As you, dearest sons and daughters, pray for your priests, that the Lord may pour out his gifts abundantly upon them and keep them faithful as ministers of Christ, the holy priest, so that they may lead you to him who is the source of salvation.
The people's response shall be, Christ hear us. Christ graciously hear us.
Christ
graciously hear us.
And pray also for me, that I may be faithful to the apostolic office entrusted to me in my lowliness, and that in your midst I may be made day by day a living and more perfect image of Christ, the priest, the good shepherd, the teacher, and servant of all.
Christ graciously hear us.
May the Lord keep us all in his charity and lead all of us, shepherds and flock, to eternal life.
Amen. I request all of you to kindly be seated. Now we begin the third part of our celebration, the liturgy of the Holy Eucharist. The ministers appointed to carry the oils together with the faithful who will carry the bread, wine, and water go to the place where the oils and other offerings have been prepared. Returning to the altar, they follow this order. First, the minister carrying the vessel of perfumed oil, then the minister with the vessel for the oil of the sick, then the minister with the vessel for the oil of the catechumens, lastly, the priest carrying the oil for the chrism. The faithful who carry the bread, wine, and water for the celebration of the Eucharist follow them. During this procession, I request all of you to kindly be in silence.
The oil of the sick
is used in the sacrament of the anointing of the sick, which has its roots in St. James chapter 5, and a long tradition in the church of interceding for the sick. By the grace of the sacrament, the whole person is helped, strengthened against temptation, ready to face the anxiety of death. Physical healing may result, and even sins may be forgiven. May the sick who will be anointed with this oil experience the compassion of Christ and his saving love in body and soul. The response will be sung. The oil of the catechumens will be used only prior to baptism. It symbolizes candidates' need for God's help and strength as they approach the sacrament of baptism. Through anointing with this oil, may our catechumens who are preparing to receive the saving waters of baptism be strengthened by Christ to resist the power of Satan, reject evil in all its appearance, and to break the bondage of past and to live as a child of God. Our response.
Blessed be God. Blessed be God. Blessed be God forever. Amen. Blessed be God. Blessed be God.
Oil of the Holy Chrism.
Holy Chrism is used in the sacrament of baptism, confirmation, ordination of priests and bishops, and consecration of the altars. Just as priests, prophets, and kings were anointed with the consecrated oil in the Old Testament, and these prefigured Christ, the Anointed One, so Christians share in the kingly, prophetic, and priestly ministry of Christ by their baptism. Through anointing with this perfumed chrism, may the children and adults who are baptized and confirmed and the priests who are ordained experience the gracious gift of the Holy Spirit. Our response.
Blessed be God. Blessed be God.
Now the Mass continues in the usual way. The choir sings the offertory hymn.
Thank you.
that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. May the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, mercifully wipe away what is old in us and increase in us grace of salvation and newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son High Priest of the new and eternal covenant, and by your wondrous design were pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the Church. For Christ not only adorns with the royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant, our Pope Francis, our Bishop Thumma Bala, the Order of Bishops, and all the clergy and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Blessing of the oil of the sick. The oil of the sick will be brought to the main altar. The minister holds it in front of the archbishop while he blesses the oil.
Lord God, loving Father, we bring healing to the sick through your Son, Jesus Christ. Hear us as we pray to you in faith, and send the Holy Spirit, man's helper and friend, upon this oil which nature has provided to serve the needs of men. May your blessing come upon all who are anointed with this oil, that they may be freed from pain and illness and made well again in body, mind, and soul. Father, may this oil be blessed for our use in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen. The vessel with the oil of the sick will be returned to its place. Now we shall have the doxology.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At this Savior's command and formed by his divine teaching, we dare to say, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory.
Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
I request the concelebrants to kindly remain in your own places as the Holy Communion will be brought to your place. I request only the Catholics to come forward to receive the Holy Communion. If there are any people who belongs to the faith of the other denomination, I request you to kindly stay in your place and pray in silence.
Morning.
Let us pray. We beseech you, Almighty God, that those you renew by your sacraments may merit to become the pleasing fragrance of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Blessing of the oil of the catechumens. The oil of the catechumens will be brought to the main altar. The minister holds it in front of the archbishop while he blesses the oil.
Lord God, protector of all who believe in you, bless this oil and give wisdom and strength to all who are anointed with it in preparation for their baptism. Bring them to a deeper understanding of the gospel. Help them to accept the challenge of Christian living and lead them to the joy of new birth in the family of your church. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Consecration of the oil of the Holy Chrism. The oil of the Holy Chrism will be brought to the main altar. The minister holds it in front of the archbishop. Archbishop pours the balsam and mixes the chrism in silence, and then he blesses the oil.
Let us pray.
let us pray that God, our Almighty Father, will bless this oil so that all who are anointed with it may be inwardly transformed and become to share in eternal salvation. God, our Maker, source of all growth in holiness, accept the joyful thanks and praise we offer in the name of your church. In the beginning, at your command, the earth produced fruit-bearing trees. From the fruit of the olive tree, you have provided us with oil for holy chrism. The prophet David sang of the life and joy of that the oil would bring us in the sacraments of love. After the avenging flood, the dove returning to Noah with an olive branch announced your gift of peace. This was a sign of a greater gift to come. Now the waters of baptism wash away the sins of men, and by the anointing with olive oil, you make us radiant with your joy. At your command, Aaron was washed with water, and your servant Moses, his brother, anointed him priest. These two foreshadowed greater things to come after your son Jesus Christ, our Lord, asked John for baptism in the waters of Jordan. You sent the Spirit upon him in the form of a dove, and by the witness of your own voice, you declared him to be your only well-beloved son, that Christ would be anointed with the oil of gladness beyond his fellow men.
I request all the concelebrants to extend your right hand towards the chrism without saying anything until the end of the prayer.
And so, Father, we ask you to bless this oil you have created. Fill it with the power of your Holy Spirit through Christ your Son. It is from him that chrism takes its name, and with chrism you have anointed for yourself priests and kings and prophets and martyrs. Make this chrism a sign of life and salvation. For those who are to be born again in the waters of baptism, wash away the evil they have inherited from sinful Adam, and when they are anointed with this holy oil, make them temples of your glory, radiant with the goodness of life that has its source in you. Through sign of chrism, grant them royal, priestly, prophetic honor, and clothe them with incorruption. Let this be indeed the chrism of salvation for those who will be born again of water and the Holy Spirit. May they come to share eternal life in the glory of your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Now we have reached to the concluding rite of the celebration. Let us remain standing while the Archbishop gives the final blessing. After the final blessing, the prayer for the priest will be recited by the Vicar General of the Archdiocese, and followed by the essence of the oils will be proclaimed by the ministers.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
I request Reverend Monsignor Swarna Bernard to recite the prayer for the priest and to propose vote of thanks. During this prayer for the priest, I request all of you to
please
kindly
take the prayer for priest on the right side of the book. Almighty and eternal God, our Father, for the love you bear for Jesus Christ, your beloved Son, the eternal High Priest, bless all the priests of Archdiocese. Remember, Lord, that they are but weak and frail human beings. Stir up in them the grace of the priestly charism which has been given to them on their ordination day by the imposition of the bishop's hands. Protect them against the assaults of the evil one, so that they may never do anything unworthy of their sublime vocation. Lord Jesus, I pray for your anointed ministers, for those who are faithful and fervent, for those who are tepid or in sin, for those who are tempted, lonely or desolate, for those who are young and those who are retired, for those dying, and for the souls of priests in purgatory. Above all, I commend to you the priests dearest to me, the priests who baptized me, those who absolved me from my sin, those whose mass I have assisted, and who gave me your body and blood in holy communion, those who taught and instructed me, or helped and encouraged me by word and example, all the priests to whom I am indebted in any way. Dear Jesus, keep all priests close to your sacred heart and bless them with an abundance of spiritual consolations here on earth and forever in heaven. Amen. Please be seated for a vote of thanks. I would like to express my deep sense of gratitude for Almighty God, for His constant care and concern for being with us this evening. We are immensely grateful to the Holy Father, Pope Francis, for declaring this year as extraordinary year of Jubilee Year of Mercy. I would like to take this opportunity to place on record our hearty thanks to His Grace, Most.Rev.Thumma Bala, for the perfect logistic support and guidance He has extended to all of us on this occasion of the Mass of the Holy Chrism and breaking the Word of God. A big thank you, dear Archbishop, for gracing this occasion. I must mention our deep sense of appreciation for all the clergy, religious, and all the people of God for being present to pray and to witness the blessing of the holy oils. A special congratulation to all the priests who have celebrated. Happy Feast Day, Fathers. I am also very grateful to Reverend Father Y. Balashivareddy, Rector and Parish Priest of St. Mary's Basilica, team members, for all the arrangements. Well, my dear people, an event like this cannot happen overnight. It requires planning and bird's eye for details. We have been fortunate enough to have Archdiocese and Liturgical Committee who meticulously planned and executed this event, namely Father Sagairas, Father Aragyaswamy, Father Korapati Jayaprathap commentator, Father Madanu Anthony. I thank for their enormous cooperation in the organization of this Holy Mass. I thank for Reverend Father Kandula Charles, Pastoral Center Director, for looking after music and choir for this event. A special greetings to the choir master and the entire choir members. I cannot thank everyone enough for their involvement and their willingness to take on the completion of tasks beyond their comfort zones. But I must mention our deep sense of appreciation to people who are responsible for Archdiocese and Curia, Father Amal, Father Prem, Father Joy Kiran, arrangements, St. Mary's Council members, parish youth, altar servers and parishioners, St. Anne sisters for preparing oils, and Sisters of Charity, Gandhi Hospital, for all those who have taken care of technical arrangements, stage setting and lighting, musicians, catechist, and so on and so forth. Once again, I want to state that we are all most grateful to all of you, dear Archbishop, dear priests, dear fathers, sisters, and all the people of God. We thank you for being with us this evening. It's been a great pleasure. I would like to make one or two announcements. I would like to remind you, a gentle reminder, that there will be a special renewal program on 19th and 20th, Saturday, Sunday, exclusively for the clergy and religious by Porta Fathers who are coming here to conduct parish mission in the evening. They will be conducting parish mission in this basilica, but during the day, morning 9:30 to 2:30, 3 o'clock, they will be conducting a special renewal program for the clergy and religious. The first day, 19th Saturday, will be at St. Mary's College of Pharmacy Auditorium. Second day, Sunday, will be at St. Anne's School Hall. Also, I would like to remind all of you that on 3rd April, we will be celebrating the Feast of Divine Mercy of Jesus, Divine Mercy of Jesus on diocesan level. We will be having program on that day, Sunday, Divine Mercy Sunday, 3 o'clock here in the Basilica Church and 5 o'clock in the St. Mary's School ground. Novena for Divine Mercy Feast begins on 25th, Good Friday, 25th March. We request all the parish priests to encourage and pray this novena so that everybody may be anointed with the mercy of God. I hope you are all aware that this basilica is celebrating 175th anniversary, and also a declaration by the Holy Father as minor basilica. To mark the occasion, the Apostolic Nuncio, Archbishop Salvatore Pennacchio, will be coming here on May 1st, and the program will be at 4:30, blessing of the church, the sacrament, Blessed Sacrament Church, and blessing of the pilgrim quarters, followed by Holy Mass at 5 o'clock. We request all of you to mark this. This is May 1st, 1st of May, Sunday, and also good number of bishops from TCBC will be participating in this occasion. I request all of you to attend this program. Thank you. God bless you all.
Now the significance of the oils will be proclaimed by the ministers. Then holy oils will be incensed by the archbishop and are carried to the sacristy by the ministers.
Behold the oil of the sick, blessed by our Archbishop, and sent to us for anointing of all who suffer illness.
Thanks be to God.
Behold the oil of the catechumens, blessed by our Archbishop, and sent to us for anointing of our catechumens in preparation for the baptism at the Vigil Mass and throughout the coming year.
Thanks be to God.
Behold the sacred chrism, oil mixed with sweet perfume, and consecrated by our Archbishop, and sent to us for the anointing of the baptized who are to be sealed with the Holy Spirit.
Thanks be to God.
Now the holy oils will be incensed by the Archbishop. Now, the holy oils will be carried in procession to the sacristy by the ministers. Kindly note, I request the concelebrants to unvest at your respective place. I request the priest to collect the holy oils either from the sacristy of St. Mary's Basilica immediately or at the Archbishop's house from tomorrow.